Hello, hello, hello. What is up, everybody? Kryllyk here, back in action with Regrowth, and we're just going to start off a little bit here. I'm still getting some more seared brick and stuff for our potential coke oven quest. There's a few other things that I do want to get done this episode, but I want to have an avid conversation with you guys here right out of the get-go. First of all, thank you to all the new subscribers, all the old subscribers, anybody who's watching this video. Very much appreciated. Thanks a ton. One quick tip, using the ingot caster from Mariculture. Very nice with the Tinker Smeltery, just saying. But anyways, my original plan for a base was to do an underwater base. Now, this is going to require quite a bit of work, and I'm fine doing that still. But I wanted to get your guys' input on what I should do. There is this nice little peninsula here. There's this nice island over here as well. We could definitely do some stuff with both of these if we wanted to build on the surface. So anyways, I'm looking forward to, leave a comment down below for an input on what we should do for our regrowth base. I also want to state, before we get into the other stuff, really exciting stuff coming to the channel near, soon. If you like it, you'll love it. Does that make sense? That didn't make sense, did it? It's fine. If you like it, you'll love it. All right? But anyways, let me get a few other things together. We have so much to do. It's not even funny. But I'll be right back. Alrighty, folks. I am back. I've done a little bit. I did some harvesting and whatnot. And we definitely need to come up with a couple things here. I just noticed this, though. There's one quest with unclaimed rewards. So I'm going to open... What? Okay. Sure. I'm happy about that. So I wonder where that opened up another quest. I honestly do not know what that opened up for us. If we can even get there at this point in time. Not a clue. Let's take a quick little glance through. We definitely need to hit this up a little bit. What the world's built from. No, there's just one there. Yeah, I don't really know what that gave us. No, nothing. I got nothing. Got nothing. Apparently I need Ember Moss. That's fine. We'll get that later. Anyways, so here we are in the world. I'm still a little bit away from the coke oven, but I wanted to take a bit of a break from that, and I want to do a couple other things instead on the world. And what were they? Oh, yes, I recall. Well, I guess we have a slime ball now, which is very, very beneficial. But anyways, so I got my 10x10x10 essence seed right there. So I'm replanting my essence seed. When this is all done, it should give me 5 stacks of essence per harvest, which is pretty freaking awesome. But equally, I have quite a few other essences and whatnot, and we're gonna see about making the this guy. The strong infusion stone, alright? So, strong infusion stone is basically created in the runic altar. It's going to require 4 regular essence, which we have, and more or less one of each essence that we need to build. Alright, so we only need 4 of these. Okay, good. We need one of each of the essence. So, we need a gold. What else do we need? We need aluminum, gold. Okay, all the rest of this, I think, is in this chest. Air, obsidian, nether, water, fire, earth, skeleton, and aluminum? Is that it? So, aluminum, skeleton, gold, earth, water, fire, air, obsidian, and blaze. Okay, so the blaze... We should have one right here. Neither of those have expanded, so that's fine. We'll just get the one to accommodate the need. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Double check that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. What? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Which one do I have that I don't need? Is it nether? It might be nether. It's nether. Okay, I don't need the nether. All right, we got them. We got it all. We got it all. 1, 2, 3, 4. Let's get this guy made. I kind of want to see what other quests are going to pop up here. Because, well, why not, right? Boom, boom, and boom. Okay, good. Nice. So, we're starting to infuse this up. It did say that it took a lot of mana, right? Over a quarter of the mana pool. So, I'm going to actually just rebind this to that mana pool, just so that we can get stuff building back up in there. But I don't know if that's accurate. It might not be accurate. We'll see. We'll see what it takes from us. You never know. But yeah, things are going very, very well in the world. I'm having still a ton of fun with this. I really want to get a base down. Now, I mean, we could keep all this as farmland, but we could also move a lot of that and just make it even better, right? I mean, there's definitely ways that I can improve on it and expand it, all right? Oh, I wanted to get more cobble cooking. 1, 2, 1, 2. Like so. Cobble cooking. Good. You need to swap. Casting table there. Ingot there. You there. Okay, we should be almost done. Perfect timing. Boom. Got it. Throw that down, and bam, nice. Okay, let's check the quest book. Strong infusion stone, very nice. Rewards, we get some strong essence and some gas tears. Awesome. And holy cow, that opened up a lot of stuff. Oh, diamonds, emeralds, glowstone, redstone. Oh my. Okay, we get glowstone. Redstone. Infuse shard. Okay. Lapis. Rutile. Alright. Spidey. Ooh, string. Ooh, that would be nice to have. All of these are going to require a lot of essence, though, if I'm not mistaken. So this one, I can hand in items for an essence of emerald. 48 bricks. Wow. That is a lot of stuff. Okay, what's diamonds? Charcoal blocks. That's a lot of wood. Anyways, that's awesome. Maybe let's look into the redstone first. Okay, let's look into the redstone seed. There we go. Okay, we require some witchery. Interesting. Witch's oven, rowan sapling, wood ash, and you get a whiff of magic. Alright, so we're definitely getting into some new and unique things here. We have a massive storage problem though, guys. Not gonna lie, it's a big time problem. So, let's first look into a little bit of the storages. Oh my. Oh my. I love it. Okay. Let's first look into, not there, this guy right here. So, I don't know if any of this is overly useful. A void bag, yeah, could be. We definitely want to complete all the quests though, so I'm going to try to accomplish some of these. So, oak drawers, last I played with these, okay, I played with these storage drawers. I wasn't a fan. Okay, I'm just going to state that first and foremost here. I was not a fan of them because of a couple reasons. We need to actually use oak. Okay. All right, that's fine. All right, so I wasn't a fan of them, and let's see. I'm not positive if they've changed or not, so we're going to find out. Okay, so let's build us some oak drawers. All right, do the I like so. Good. Oak drawers. Let's take a look. We got our quest. And we get some oak drawers 2x2. Ah. Okay, we already made the dolly. I'm getting the barrels. You know what? Before I make this decision. Okay. Let's take a brief look at these. Alright. So, oak drawers. Basically, you can store things in the drawers. Alright. And you can store a certain amount of stuff. So, for example, netherrack, right? I can store a netherrack there, and it'll show you. And if you hit it with your hand, it'll take it. If you shift-click, it'll take the whole thing out, right? Pretty straightforward. But, like I said, I'm not a huge fan, and I'm still not a huge fan of those. It could potentially work well. Let's see how much it can hold. Okay, I have a whole bunch of iron. Essence of iron. And I want to see if it can hold or how much it can hold. Because I was under the assumption these guys had a cap of some kind. But maybe they don't. Maybe this is actually a cool way to store our essence. I might have to, you know what? Let's give these things a try. Let's see what they're like. Alright? Okay, yeah, let's see what these are like. Why not? Okay, let's grab our hatchet and remove them and see what they're like before we decide. Okay, yeah, mousing over them, you can see that this holds 8 stacks and this holds 4 stacks. We will not be using these, guys. I'm sorry, but we will not be using these at this point in time. I might try to find a use for them in the near future, but not right now, okay? So let's claim the reward of the Jabba barrels. Okay, claim that. Good. All right, now there is upgrades for these where you can upgrade the amount that they, you know, go in and all that kind of stuff. But because we're not really going to use it, I'm just going to do one here to get the quest done. And what's the thing called? Storage drawers. Okay, so we need the upgrade template, which is basically one of these drawers surrounded by sticks. Okay, we can do that quite easily. We'll put those away. So one of these drawers surrounded by sticks. Pretty straightforward. Nothing too complicated about this. Upgrade template. Okay. Boom. Pick one. Storage upgrade 5 or 10 storage upgrade 2s. Oh, we have to get a storage upgrade 2 now. Okay. So storage upgrade 2 is iron with some more sticks. All right. Let's do some sticks here. That's fine. And get a couple pieces of iron. Good. I believe it was iron on the outside. Sticks in the middle with one of these upgrade templates. Okay. Good. Pick one. That one. And that's it. Okay, so we're done that quest. We need to do a structural upgrade for a better barrel, which is fine. We will do that. This can go back away. I want to set up a bit of a storage section here for my essences. So what I think I'm going to do is just right here. Boom. Like so. Nice big storage. Basically for all of the different essences. So that'll be our iron. This will be, say, our gold. We'll lock them. All of our copper can go in one. Basically, all the essences. I don't want to turn them into their other forms at this point in time for storage. I want to keep them in their essence form. Why? I don't know. It's kind of what I decided. All right. Okay. Tin. Good. Coal. Good. What else do we have? Earth is going to be a big one. Skeleton, we could probably start doing more of again. now, and skeleton like so. Okay, good. That at least frees up some of these chests so that we can utilize them for more storages and stuff like that. Very nice. That's exactly what I wanted. Let's see about that. We got more. Good. Okay, so now we need to make an MK upgrade. All right, I'm going to use up the rest of this dead wood, and we're actually going to steal this barrel as well. Eventually. Harvest level copper. What? Really? Okay. Good. We'll go over here with it then. I guess we have to use the dolly. Not a big deal. Good and good. So we do have some stickers. We got the barrel hammer from a previous quest. But for right now, I just want to make sticks out of the deadwood. And we need to make a structural upgrade. MK structural upgrade MK1. Okay. Let's make sure that this hasn't changed. I think it has. Yes, it has. Okay. Oh my god. Oh, all right. That's a lot more expensive. So basically, we need logs around fences times 4. Okay. So fences. Oh, at least that hasn't changed. Let's get a decent amount of those. 12 should do for now. And we'll place them around like so. Good. Now we need logs, which I do have a decent amount of. I did make a lumber axe. I'm not sure if you guys saw that there, but I did make a lumber axe. So 6 times 4 is 24 logs. Good. It's kind of been a little bit helpful, but I haven't done too much with trees. I really wish that we could get a little bit more into the automation side of things now. But what can you do, right? Okay, a couple of those. I'm just going to throw that in there and get our 4 copper to make our MK1 upgrade. Awesome. So now what do we need to make? A storage upgrade. Okay, storage upgrade. Hasn't changed. Okay, so it's pistons with a better barrel inside. So let's take this guy. Let's take that guy. And let's make ourselves a 2 pistons. Now, luckily, they only require levers. I believe, I'm not sure if that changes once you get redstone. I've heard a few rumors that it does, but we'll see. And if I get redstone, meh. Oh, really? You're going to come into my neck of the woods, are you, Enderman? Apparently. All right. Let's just take these last 9. I'm sure we'll use them at some point. Okay. And get those into planks. 2 pistons. Like so, around a better barrel is going to give us a storage upgrade. Good. Excellent. We get 2 more storage upgrades. And we get 3 mark ones or 1 mark 2. Alright, let's see. Okay, mark 2 is basically the same as a mark 1, but it keeps going up and up. Okay. I think I'm just gonna get the mark 1s from this quest. Because we get 3 of them. And each one of those costs 4 logs and 4 sticks. Compared to one of these only costs 4 logs and, no, sorry, 16 logs, 16 sticks. Whereas this one costs 48 logs, 48 sticks, and more copper. So I'm going to take the copper one. And let's see, a void upgrade. All right, void upgrade. I wonder if this is the same. 2 more pistons. It is around an obsidian. We have obsidian. We should be able to do this quite easily, actually. Let's get 2 more pistons going. Like so. I actually am going to need more cobble, of all things. 1, 2. And 1, 2. Good. Great. We really need to get... I'm really looking forward to a bit of automation. Some say I'm still a long ways off. Some don't. So there we go. Void upgrade. Nice. And I'm going to take this... We get those. I don't get to take one. Okay. So we're almost done this section. A void bag is not all that expensive, all things considered. I think that I'm going to store all of this stuff in here for now. So let's take a look at what we have for string. We have a decent amount. So let's see. Takes 4 of those. 4 string. I only have 2 string. Okay. Let's go harvest. Oh, what? Okay, we got enough. Good. Let's get the last bit of string here. Rip in pepperonis, Mr. Cotton crop. We'll just place you down there. Grow, be fruitful. All right, good. We'll throw that up there. And an ender pearl. Luckily, we have loads of ender pearls. Let's make the void bag. Nice. And accept that quest as well. We get a void chest from that. Which, in my opinion, is a pretty nice reward. Oh my god, guys. We have officially completed a whole page in the quest book. How awesome is that? I am stoked about that. That is so cool. All right. Let's smelt down some more cobble. More cobble. I could do compressed. I could... actually, can you do compressed? I don't know if you can. You might be able to. If I could have done compressed and melt that down, but that's a different story. So I think we actually have enough seared bricks to make ourselves the sand that we need to make ourselves the coke oven. Okay, coke oven. Good. Of course. Of course you're not going to work for me. Okay, we'll do this. That's 16. 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh, man, we are very, very close. Okay. Boom. Boom, boom. It's 24. 24 is the magic number that we need. And we might get it right here. Let me just sleep off this night and I'll be right back. Alrighty, there we go. Nighttime over. Get some more seared brick here. All that stuff. Oh man, we are so close. Alright, let's make the 22. Actually, no, you know what? Oh man, I need 26, don't I? Okay, hold on. What do I need? I need 26 of them. No! Alright. So, I'm going to need even more seared brick and stuff, but you know what? We're very close. Let's finish this, and then we'll call it an episode. We'll set up the coke oven. Alrighty, there we go. 26 coke oven. Oh, really? We have to make 16 coal coke? Because that's not annoying. Okay, let's build this guy. So it's basically a 3x3, okay? So you build it up like so, and it's going to be hollow in the middle, okay? Just like this, very similar to the water tank that we did next door. Now, the one benefit of this is it's very, very easy to use. And actually, let's just not use essence at the moment. Let's just grab a stack of coal. So you basically throw coal in there. It doesn't need anything else but time. It's going to take a while to process through all of that coal and turn it into coal coke. As you can see, the progress bar, pretty darn slow. But you know what? We're very close to finishing up this coke oven. Anyways, guys, that's going to be it for this episode. We're already up wrapping up point, which is insane things are going by so fast, it seems. But there's still so much to do. I'd really appreciate the ideas and tips on the different base ideas that I kind of mentioned. Or if anybody else has any other cool ideas that I didn't even think about, please feel free to comment down below. You can also get me on my Twitter. I'm at Kryllyk. And make sure you follow me on Twitch as well. I've still been doing the City Skyline streams, but I might do the odd Minecraft one as well. So keep that in mind. Anyways, guys, that's going to be it for me. Make sure you leave a like. Make sure you subscribe. Make sure you say hi. Hi. See ya.